Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Josh Mahony, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. So today we're going to take a look at what's moving the markets, and you know, it's a sort of holiday period, so it's lower volumes at the moment, but at the top of the agenda again it's the fiscal cliff, and we expect to get a resolution over the next few days. Well, we have to, because the deadline is on the 1st of January. We've got a meeting of the Democrats today who are trying to thrash out a piece of legislation to put forward to the House of Representatives, and they're meeting on Sunday to try and ratify the bill or not do so, and therefore the country will go over the fiscal cliff. See, what I expect is that we're actually going to get some sort of watered down version of it, whereby the people earning $250,000 a year or less are going to get their tax cuts extended, and we'll just see some sort of extension to what we've got currently with regards to those high earners, but it's more sort of kicking the can down the roads per se, and where they'll make the decision later in 2013, maybe 6 months, maybe a year's time. The impact on the markets, should this happen, is likely to be dependent on how long it's actually going to be kicked down the road. You know, if they extend it for say 2 years, then the markets are probably going to think, great, we don't have to think about this for 2 years. If they do so for 3 months, 6 months, then really we're just going to be back in the same position in a very short period of time. So if you look at what actually is going to happen if they did go over the fiscal cliff, many commentators have actually said that it's more likely to be more of a sort of fiscal hill than a fiscal cliff, because a lot of what's actually being introduced, should the country go over it, will take some time to happen. So don't expect all of a sudden this country to implode and all of a sudden the stock markets completely crash. The only reason that they'd crash is because people would actually worry, and people don't actually have enough detail on what is going to happen. So, you know, it's a very important time. We've got to follow the markets closely. And if you look across to the currency markets, there appears to be some sort of indecisions. They don't really know which way to move, because in essence, all of the currency pairs that have the US dollar in it are wholly reliant on this fiscal cliff to actually get any sort of decent sense of direction. Taking a look at the Japanese economy, today the finance minister actually said that they would actively move within the currency markets to overvalue or undervalue their currency and actually try and change how well it is sort of appreciated or depreciated within the markets. I mean, what it essentially says is that they're going to be a sort of currency manipulator per se, in the same way that Mitt Romney classified China as such. It doesn't really mean too much. All it means is that they're doing exactly the same as the likes of the UK and the US, who are doing it by means of QE. But what they're doing is that they're saying that it's done as a means to stimulate the economy, whereas the Japanese are actively saying, look, we want to devalue our currency because it makes us more competitive. That's why their economy has been struggling in the past, and therefore they're actively going to devalue their currency. Taking a look at the cable chart, it's kind of bounced back off that 1.63 mark, which was a high dating back from September 2012 and then some time before that. I mean, there's been pretty clear swings in the price level, and so we've had some decent trading action for people, and it's dropped back towards this 23.6 Fibonacci level. So, you know, I don't expect any sort of decent price movement below that 23.6 level. I mean, you can see that there's that 100-day moving average pushing up towards it, so that's going to act as support as it gets nearer that. Neither do I expect it to go above that 1.63 mark, which has tried to break above in previous times, but it's failed to. What we're going to actually see is probably some sort of repositioning of traders in anticipation of the fiscal cliff, and it's going to take some sort of decision one way or the other on a fiscal cliff to actually break below or above those levels. Now, looking at the euro dollar, again, it's the same kind of story. It's that 1.33 mark with the euro dollar that it's unwilling to push above. It's that high dating back from April 2012. So again, it's tried to do it twice. It's got sort of formed a double top formation, which usually is a bearish formation, but given the sort of political overtones that you've got coming out of the US, I wouldn't be surprised to see it go higher or lower, and in the meanwhile it should be trading within this kind of tight range that we can see marked out with the blue two lines. So, you know, what we're expecting is for the markets to be sort of teetering along and waiting for some sort of resolution on the fiscal cliff before we get any sort of decent sense of direction. So that's it for today, guys, and if you want to check out any more news or analysis, come and look at the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom, or check me out on Twitter. My name's Josh Mahony, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.